number of birth princes defeat of giant crab. Long ago, a giant crab living in a deep hole at a bottom of an ocean passed that it will crawl up to search for food. When it leaves, the hole will fill up with water. Since the crab is so large, so it took the whole of the water along the shore to fill the hole. When the crab finished eating, it crawled back into its hole. The water was searched up, back out, sucking it more high up to the shore. Some people call this time of a day hunted and loaded. One evening, a princess was walking along the seashore looking at ocean. Suddenly, she saw an island reached out of the ocean and started walking toward the shore. That's not an island, that was a giant crab. This crab was taller than his island's tallest tree or mountains. Then the princess looked at the crab's giant pinchers and eyes. The crab was looking at the moon at its roots. The princess looked the crab, opened its pinchers, and tried to pinch and bite the moon. It ran out following the moon as it climbed higher. Then the crab retorted and tried to crab it. Next step, the crab snapped it pinchers. That sounds like the third. If the crab caught the moon and ate it, the night of the sky will be dark forever. The princess lost her people at a fest. People were dancing and having fun. No one would see the crab until it was too late. She needed help to stop the crab from eating moon. Suddenly, the princess had an idea. She found an empty couch shell, put it to her lips, and blew. A loud noise came out. Ooh. The princess looked the crab's larger pinchers get colder and closer to the moon. Snap, snap, snap. She floated in the shell again and again. The crab's pinchers get closer and closer to the moon. The princess blew one more time with a loud blast yet. When the sound stayed out, the drum stopped beating. The princess looked toward the village and looked a line of torture came toward her. The waving line of the torture looked like a large snake came down the mountainside on the way to the beach. She brought the shell one more time and ran toward her people. The warriors armed ended with sharp knife and spears appeared. When they their eyes shot the pier, when they saw the largest soul of the largest crab that they had ever saw. It crept the moon. One pinchers appeared taller than before and almost caught the moon, but the moon was fear of the crab's drift, and the crab was fell on her back. The peasant grabbed a spear and ran to where the crab was trying to get up. She ran out of sight of the crab. She undid her spear to the crab's soft belly and subbed it. Every walrus do the same while dodging the pinchers. One walrus cut off one of the pinchers, then another pincher was cut off. Soon the crab was dead and the moon was dead. The bravery of the princess saved the moon. The night sky are still lit by the moon. Ship can sail by the light of moon. The water of ocean still going from high tide to low tide and back again. People say that is the pool of the moon that caught this tide. But the islanders say it is water still following in and out of the crab's home at the bottom of the ocean.